For as long as we both shall live. You are listening to Al Piano. If you were listening to a king, I might be telling you that you are listening to a piece of the past, to a man of the past, but I'm not. If you were listening to Bessie Wallace Warfield, you would be listening to a version. His Majesty, his love for this woman, expounded into... You are listening to a history of our piano. If I were a king, which I'm not, I would be telling you that you are listening to a piece of the past, to a man of the past, but I am not. If you are listening to Bessie Wallace Warfield, you would hear a version of His Majesty, his love for this woman, whose acquaintance with two previous living husbands, Wynne Spencer and Wynne Ann Simpson, was the epitome of the degradation such extols the class consciousness, the extravagances of lust, and the prejudices exposed are such that a whole nation may gloat over the tragedy that descends a king from such throne. Consciousness, the extravagances of lust over the tragedy that descends a king from such throne. In December 1936, which had only been succeeded in January 36 of the death of his father, King George V. But I am not Wallace Simpson. She is not this commoner who marries a king. I might be the Queen of the Scots, or I might be certainly in love to his destiny. We went, my boyfriend and I, to a hotel in Berkeley Square, where we heard the pianists Ravitz and Landauer playing to their hearts' malcontent. Why mal? Why? Because it was all gone, this old Vienna, of the Contessa of France, of the Queen, who to Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart was the mother and patron, that mothered King Leopold II, and whose concert Mozart performed and attended in 1790, a year before he died. But I am not this Queen of Austria. But we sat and really listened to this Landauer, whose father, a Viennese violinist, was the institution by which Walt, as he called him, came to the piano. And for Ravitz, whose history was by no means absolutely divorced from Great Britain, was enshrouded in the tragedies of the First World War and demobilization through ill health, that my boyfriend suggested that they do not adopt a tour of the United States, that instead they entertain such possibility of a visit of a future to the realms of possibility to entertain throughout Great Britain. But my boyfriend, who is going to be king, does not wish to be. Ed would be my third husband, but for the throne standing in the way of desire.
But I have to tell you in all honesty that my boyfriend never wanted to be king.
Thank you.
Well, it will not be. Love possesses many a chalice of destiny, but it is always outside of the chalice that places the sordid chastity of emptiness before a throne such to be king. My boyfriend will in fact abdicate. I have not been able to tell this small country the future that America already knows back in Baltimore is doomed by any other succession such as his. The better be his brother attains the throne as King George VI. Who could think of any better duet to play upon a piano as Rabbit, as Landauer, or better duet to play upon a throne as Edward or as George? This is his winter, that his discontent enshrouded in honesty to declare his love for me.
I am yours. Thank you.
Wallace, Warfield. For as long as we both shall live.
Bessie, Wallace, Warfield.
I am yours.